Good luck. All right, let's just get this started. I'll explain it again when we're in the game. I'll explain it again when we're in the game. Okay. I'll explain what game we're playing. This is a new game mode called competitive 1v4s, because usually a 1v4 would be pretty uncompetitive. It would just be a stomp. The team of four would win very handily. So this is a special 1v4 where the team of four are not allowed to boost, and if they do boost by accident, then they have to go to the sin bin, aka the spectate. That's where I am. I'm in the sin bin already for a whole minute. So first up in the team of one, we have Remkoe. So he's allowed to boost. And in the team of four, we have Jessie from Summit. We have Doomsee from Reunited. Look at him, he can't boost. He's trying to fire a shot in the net. What a bullet by Doomsee to get things started off. Let's see what happened to Remkoe over here. Oh, Jessie just driving right in the way of Remkoe. The speed, the power of Doomsee's shot. But Jessie was a real MVP there. He just bumped to Remkoe. He just drove right in front of Remco. That's the kind of thing you need to do if you're on the team of four. You have to use foul tactics. But also, we have Stocki featured, and Stocki's countryman Reepex, probably I'd say the fourth best player from Switzerland. Lesser known player in the EU scene, but he is a very high level Grand Champion player. Let's see how these guys do. They are allowed to pick up boost pads, but they're not allowed to boost, is the problem. Remco, though, he's allowed to boost. And I'm not sure if anybody's actually ever won a 1v4 in this manner. But if you do keep the scoreline lower than anybody else in the lobby, because everybody's going to get a shot to play as the 1v4, if you get the best overall score, then you win. So, oh my goodness, Reepix with the zero boost shot. Remco a little bit cheeky there, going at the halfway line to grab the boost. And Reepix, let's see, he did not use boost, just a well done shot by him into the open net. 2-0 under a minute. Remco might be in trouble. Oh, Mike won the very first, so the very first 1v4, Mike actually won. So the winner is the guy on his own who doesn't lose the most, or the guy who wins, potentially. Doomsie has already lost faith, but I mean, you could just win. Oh, Reepix and Stocki both going for boost in a game mode where they're not allowed to use boost. I don't even know. What were they thinking? It's that, you know, it's hard to break those habits. I'm sure that these guys who are on the team who aren't allowed to use boost are probably still driving over the boost pads everywhere that they go. But okay, Remco actually bringing it back within one, and you can see that there are definitely ways to win this. That's not a bad touch by Reepix, actually, considering he's not allowed boost, and Stocki with the interception as well. They are making some pretty good plays, but obviously you can't go for an aerial if you don't have boost. Jessie finding that one out right there. A Reepix with the mad air dribble off the wall with no boost. Again, those things are not very successful. Oh, Jessie with the save, but Remco's got a free aerial. Nobody on blue team can jump higher than halfway up the goal. Oh, what? The zero boost dunk! Is it gonna go in? It is Reepix with the dunk from zero boost. What a play. Look at this. He just slams him. That's actually a really good early flip, to be honest. Reepix for president, says Stocki. His second goal in the zero boost team. Pretty impressive stuff. Again, going for another prediction dunk, and Doomsie with the save attempt, but it's not gonna work. Remco has the advantage on kickoffs. Blue team really need to try and spread out here. Doomsie covering the center of the goal, but he can't get the save on the joint. And Stocki actually went for boost again, I have to highlight. He keeps going for boost, even though he's not allowed to use it. Okay, this time he didn't do it. Like, he's still collecting the boost pad. Although, there is, I guess, there's one reason to collect the boost pad, and that is that then it's not available for Remco to pick up. So at the start of the game, when they haven't filled up their boost bar, you could argue that, you know, they're picking it up so that Remco can't. But still, it's pretty funny when you think of it. The kickoffs are just so one-sided. Blue team just have to try and spread out and try not to all go for the same ball. And right now, we might actually see somebody committing to bump duty. Jesse's gonna do it. He's just chasing down Remco right now. He's trying to annoy Remco to give one of his teammates an open net. Jesse's still on bump duty. He's just kind of ignoring the ball for the most part until it comes towards him and just trying to bump Remco. He might do it again. Yeah, he's going. He's just looking for Remco. He's trying to go over the bump. Doomsie might do the same thing here. Oh, he actually gets the center ball, but nobody on blue team approaching it with any speed. What a shot. What a shot by blue team. A thunderous strike wide of the net. Sounds Stocki actually annoying Remkoe. Remkoe still, you know, he's keeping it pretty close. Oh, there's the bump! Vicious stuff, and now Stocky's got the open net! Reepex gets the steal! Holy cow, I wonder who got the bump there. It was actually Jessie! Holy cow, he sent Remkoe flying, and then Doomsee's goal got stolen by Reepex with the hat trick. That's an impressive steal by Reepex. The zero boost pop. For anybody just joining us, this is the 1v4 game mode where the team of four are not allowed to use boost. So it can be pretty interesting. And again, Jessie is just hunting Remkoe right now. Oh my goodness, the passing play. Look at this, my blue team. Oh, Stocki had to early flip to try and reach the ball, but he couldn't get there in time. Oh, Reepex accidentally hits it the wrong way. Stocki off the wall, can't get it to the bounce. There's nothing that blue team can do to stop this vicious strike by Remkoe. It just bounces in and nobody can reach it. What a disaster. They're still in the game. Oh, fake kickoff by Remkoe. Because he's figured that the other team are just trying to block his kickoffs because they know he's getting there first. He could still win this, could Remkoe. He just needs to be a little bit more careful. Especially, he's got to look out for Jessie, who has been hunting him. Oh, speaking of hunting, will Doomsee go for the bump? Now, Doomsee liking to get forward, but still prioritizing the ball over Remkoe. I feel like that's something that blue team could do a lot better, is they could just send one player to chase Remkoe around the field, like Jessie is trying to do now. Oh, they've got the team play, though. Oh, Stocki missed the open net! What a horrendous misplay. Stocki letting his team down, and a Remkoe with a free aerial. That should be another goal, and it is. Oh, wait, what? Jesse's on the line. I couldn't even see him. Oh, my goodness. Jessie is a hero. Doomsee going for the zero boost turtle. Jessie is an absolute hero for this team right now. Gets another dunk goal. Holy cow. That was a pretty sick save. The ball, like, eclipsed Jessie. I couldn't even see him. I didn't even know he was there. Oh, the fake kickoff. And now Reepex is just hunting Remkoe. Luckily for Remkoe, the zero boost dribbles are not very scary. It's actually still three goals in it. Oh, Jessie getting slammed. Reepex is actually causing so many problems, though, for Remkoe. He's playing very well with the zero boost. I'm very impressed. Okay, let's see. Can Remkoe make the scoreline look any better? He might still win with this score. Whoa, Reepex with another block. This guy is insane with no boost. Reepex, maybe he's just really bad at hitting boost pads and he's actually just driving around all the time with no boost, so this is like his natural habitat or something, because he's just been insane this game. So many points in the no boost game. Accidentally double jumping though, not a good play. Should be a goal for Remkoe, and it is. Nice rebound by Remkoe. Let's take a look at what he saw here. So he goes for the fast kickoff, deliberately chips it high. Jessie, not much he can do. Doomsee, close but no cigar. Oh, Remkoe could do it again. I wonder if he's going to do the same thing. Fast kickoff. Doesn't get blocked. Oh, this is dangerous. Jessie does get the save. That time Remkoe couldn't hit the crossbar on purpose, which is kind of what he's trying to do. Because every time he hits the crossbar, somebody has to drive up on the wall to get the save. Which, again, that might be something that blue team incorporate into their game. Is sending somebody, like, up each wall beside their goal on every kickoff. Because you have so many people. You could send one person for the ball, one person in the goal, one person up each wall to try and, you know, defend against all angles. But, these guys, most of them, I think Jesse's played this game mode before. No one else has played it. So this is the first time. I think, yeah, this is pretty rough for Remkoe. Jessie goes in for the bump, forcing Remkoe to jump up, and then nice pass by Doomsee for Reepex, again, the goal scorer. So pretty decent play. Will it remain at four? Remkoe has shown some prowess on the kickoffs. Fast kickoff down the middle, Doomsee is there. This should probably mean that the game is finishing at four goal difference. Remkoe negative four, which is respectable, unless he can do a miracle here and keep up the ball. Nope, that's gonna do it. Okay, Remkoe negative four. So pretty good game. Quite a few funny goals. We'll make a note of that. We'll make a note of Remco's scoreline. There we go. Where is it? There it is. Okay, so Remkoe is on negative four. Alright, someone volunteer to be the next tribute. Someone needs to volunteer to be the next tribute. All right, Doomsie's up. It's decided. Doomsie wants a go to be this being the solo player. Good luck, Doomsie, who was, you know, he did his part, but he got outscored by his teammates. Reepex was insane. Jessie, the most aggressive player on the bump side of things. So pretty interesting. So yeah, he's got to beat negative four, Doomsie. But, I mean, there's still three players to go after him, so ideally he wants to try more than negative four. Hey, Jigil95.
Fantastic. More of these.
More of these. Hey, I'm glad you're enjoying it. This is just a game mode that I thought of yesterday when there were five people in a lobby on someone else's stream. It was actually Yumi Cheeseman's stream. There were five people in a lobby and they were thinking of a game to do. They were like, could we do 2v3, 1v4s? So I was just like, huh, why not 1v4s where the team of four can't use boost? And it turns out it's actually a really, you know, fun game mode to watch and to play. Remkoe, actually. The zero boost play, hashtag who needs boost. Well played by Remkoe. Reepex keeps going for the boost on kickoffs. It is a hard thing to prevent yourself from doing. Ah, Doomsie. Again, advantage on the face-off because he is the only one with boost. That's a good shot. Remco's getting some really good power on the ball despite not having boost. Oh, this could be a goal. Reepex trying to flip early. Of course, it's the moment that you do front flip, you gain that speed boost, so sometimes you have to flip sooner than you would want to. Oh, the pressure gets to Doomsie. He's already down by two, 420 remaining, and he blazes it in. Ha 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 ha. I'm such a good caster. Doomsie's saying it's actually much harder than he thought. Yeah, it's difficult. It's difficult. We'll see. This is obviously quite a new thing. And I imagine that if the team of four, like, play with a good structure and a good, like, idea of where everybody's supposed to go on kickoff, because like we have noticed a few times, a lot of these players on kickoff are still going for boost, even though they're on the team that aren't allowed to use boost. That, of course, would not happen if the players were more familiar with this format. And I think that if players just get used to this, the team of four would dominate even harder. But we'd have to wait and see. The same can be said for the team of one solo player. He might get really good at 1v4ing. Oh, yeah, not a good touch by Doomsie. It might be an own goal. And Trixari with the 4 months in a row. Thank you for the resub, dude. Welcome back. Boy, hello. Hope you are enjoying this new game mode, which I'm sure you guys will have a lot of fun trying yourself, because of course you only need four friends. And if you don't have four friends, oh, the triple jump by Blue Team. No faith in their teammates' defensive capabilities right there. Oh, look at that zero boost throw. Nice play. Oh, Stocki misfiring again, though. Not good play. Jessie with an open net. Goes for the mind game. And oh, what a play. Jessie gets the mind game with no boost. Oh, my goodness. Look at this play. He just fakes Doomsie out of the goal completely. Gets his goal stolen, but what a goal by Jessie. That was insane. Holy cow. And yeah, like the Yumi Cheeseman said in the chat, maybe 3v1 is a perfectly balanced game mode. We'll see. We'll have to experiment with this more. I mean, there's no harm in giving it a go. Oh my god, Blue Team are just insane! How are they doing this? Do you guys see what I'm seeing? Look at this team pinched by Remkoe and Jessie. What a play. They could have probably run it into the open net anyway, but Doomsie was on the recovery. That he might have made it back in time. That was honestly really impressive. Calculated. Doomsie's getting rinsed here. Blue Team are on another level right now. I wonder if anybody can actually beat the team of four today. We'll find out. We'll see. I mean, the fact that it's so difficult, or, you know, Doomsie and Remkoe are struggling so much kind of shows how difficult a challenge it is. And if somebody can beat that challenge, it's, you know, all the more impressive. So, we'll see. We'll do quite a few of these lobbies, I feel, today. It's quite funny. Quite funny to see. Can Doomsie even score is one of the questions right now. Oh, he gets the dribble. Doesn't go for the fake, though, on Remkoe. Remkoe just shutting down that attack. Oh, look at the team play by Blue Team again, and this time Stocki does find the open goal. Good play by Blue Team. They're just doing what they have to do. Doomsie overcommitting again. He's playing very aggressively for a team of one. And did I? Don't know if I missed a sub. I don't think I missed a sub. I'm sorry if I did. Change the... Oh yeah, I should probably change my title. You're right. Competitive 1v4... What is it? What? games. There we go. Oh my goodness. Doomsie's getting rinsed here. He's getting absolutely rinsed. He just gets stuck in the most awkward position ever. Dunked on by Reepex, and Jesse's in the middle. This is brutal. He's getting completely rinsed. Will he even score a goal? He's down by 7. Remkoe lost by 4 goals. He's going for another fake kickoff. It seems, you know, it's a pretty safe strategy to mix in there, the fake kickoff. Doomsie again, so aggressive. I feel like he isn't doing enough baiting. He's not trying to bait the team of 4 forward very much. And then counterattack. Kind of leaving himself open to get counterattacked on by a team who are moving about as fast as a snail. Oh, the demo from behind. Dirty by Doomsie. And oh, the air dribble. He accidentally hits it backwards though. That would have been pretty nice, but lost control of the ball. He is rotating wide again to go for the boost steal. Reepex. Did not see Stocki coming, or he would have left that, probably. Did Stocki just steal a boost? How did Stocki steal this boost? Did he not have maximum boost? Wow, okay, so I guess, like, since the last kickoff, Stocki still had not driven over enough boost to reach 100 boost. That's impressive. Because you can go for boost steals. You start off the game with 34 boost if you're on blue team. And then you can steal a boost if you don't drive over the pads. You could, you know, deliberately try to steal the big one if you just dodge all the small pads. Because, of course, if you do reach 100 boost, then you can't steal the big ones. And you want to be able to steal the big ones from Doomsie, because he's the only one who can use them effectively. Jessie going for the bump, by the way, and then Doomsie passes it to Remkoe. He's down by 9! Jessie just forcing the play out of Doomsie. Look at this, he's just trying to harass Doomsie to force him to hit the ball before he gets bumped, and then slammed into the middle by Remkoe. 9-0. Doomsie's getting demolished here. It's probably a good idea that he went on early, but it's pretty scary to think how good these guys are going to be at 4v1ing by the time we're done this. Poor Doomsie, you're not wrong. It is very much poor Doomsie. He's just surrounded by these annoying little bots that, you know, they're so slow, but they won't go away. There's so many of them. Doomsie, will he score a goal? Down, he's under a minute remaining. He's not going to beat Remco's score, that's for sure. Remkoe is almost certainly going to beat Doomsie in this challenge. Today, at least. And Jessie, oh my goodness, the zero boost control carrying the ball. It's very difficult to carry the ball with no boost. He tried to predict Doomsie's jump. Jessie going for another bump right there. Jumped above Doomsie because he expected Doomsie to jump over him. So either Doomsie didn't see him coming, or he, you know, mind game Jessie by not jumping. The do nothing and win mind game. That's what I like to see. Doomsie's struggling. He can hardly get the ball out of his own half. And, you know, Remkoe, similarly to how he likes to play in 3v3, is just sitting back at the half and intercepting everything. There's the 10th goal. Doomsie lets in another one. Jessie again harassing Doomsie. And this time Remkoe gets the interception. Jessie is definitely showing us pretty good. Like, he's showing us how effective it can be to just drive at the opponent. Just harass them. Just show them that you're going to bump them. You don't even have to bump them. You just need to be there. And that's going to be Doomsie's last shot of the game, I'm sure. 10-0. Unless we get another crazy goal, which I'm not expecting. Oh, it does stay up somehow. That's a decent pass into the middle by Jessie. Oh my goodness, our blue team gonna do this? Oh my word, what a team play! Jessie, the absolute hero. Look at that pass. Jessie to Reepex to Jessie to Remkoe. All with no boost. 11-0. Doomsie gets demolished right here. I can't believe they scored that goal. That was impressive stuff by blue team. And Doomsie goes negative 11, the poor guy. Who did Mike beat? It was like VS Dumbo, Quinn, Yumi Cheeseman. Yumi and Jessie. Oh wait, who's next? Okay, Reepex is gonna go next. That's good. Who would be the top 3 most eligible players to beat the 4? I think Cuxer would be pretty good at this. Scrubkiller would be pretty good at this. Probably Marky as well. Remkoe wasn't on the 4. I hope Jessie joins in here. Jessie. There he is, okay. Remkoe saying that with him on the team of four, it's going to be a different story. And I mean, so far, he's at a 100% win record. Okay, Jessie not going for the kickoff. This might, or no, Reepex, they're not going for the kickoff. Maybe trying to play that defensive counterattack strategy, but will it work if he... Oh my goodness, Stocki getting the dunk on the missed open net from Jessie. He needs to get better 50-50s than that. Yo, Scuttle Oleg. Or Scoot Oleg. I forgot there was no L in your name. That's a ton of chairs, man. Thank you so much. I can't add up that in my head, but I really appreciate that, dude. Thanks for the support. Will Reepex beat Doomsee? Will he beat Remkoe? There's a lot of questions that need answering. This game mode, of course, still new for all of us. That's good play by Reepex, finding himself some space. He's got to be so careful not to take himself out of the game, because in theory, it should be pretty easy to save every shot, but if he takes himself out of the game like that, then he opens himself up to get exploited. Remkoe actually going supersonic there because he flipped enough times. Well played by Remkoe, really nice center ball. Reepex down by two. And yeah, pretty short duration gone. Remkoe knows that's at the crossbar. Oh my goodness, what a save actually. I didn't see who hit that ball, but whoever did, it was either Stocki or Jessie, is a genius because they actually kept it in an unscorable position. Reepex, if he was hanging about, going for a rebound, would not have been able to score that. Scoot Oleg again, or Scutty Oleg, I don't know how to say that word. If you want me to pronounce it properly, say it in phonetic, or type it in phonetic in chat. Dude, just providing the chairs today. Thank you so much, man. That's awesome. That's an easy interception for Reepex. He knows that he's going to win that with no one on the other team boosting. I wonder how the spacing will work for these guys, because they, of course, they're only used to challenging people who do have boost. This will definitely favor people who play a lot of 1v1s, because boost starving is a big part of 1v1s, and 1v1 players will be more familiar of, you know, how fast a car can challenge the ball with no boost. That jump by Reepex made him land pretty much in Africa, so he couldn't get back in time. 3-0. Looking pretty one-sided again. This is making Remco's score look even better. Making Remkoe look like a 1v4 genius at the moment. I'm curious to see how Jessie does, because Jessie has had the most practice at this game mode, and I wonder if that will help him at all. Whoa, Reepex going for a blind no-look save. That is showing a ton of respect to Remkoe behind him, the fact that he's going for that save. He didn't get a touch on the ball. He says it's horrible. He can't believe how hard it is. It's just so annoying. There's all these little blue cars everywhere you go, and they're just in the way. Doomsee's saying you feel so much more powerful, yet at the same time so powerless. Another dunk. Oh, this is going to be a tough save. Not even savable. Stocki with the dunk this time. And Reepex is down by 5 goals. Oh, that's not a good 50-50 by Reepex, I have to say. He just pretty much hit the ball straight up the wall into Stocki. My underscore I LOL. You like it? I'm just stealing Jazer's meme, dude. Gotta steal that meme. It's the equivalent of having a zombie horde chasing you in-game. That's pretty close to how this looks. I'm just going to follow Stocki for a little bit here. We've not been looking at what he's been doing, but it looks like he's deciding to sit back, be the last man in on most rotations. Of course, hitting a high ball like that does give Reepex a chance to score a perfect aerial underneath the crossbar, but pretty difficult to do that consistently, for sure. And of course, there will be large portions of these games where the single player is low on boost himself. That's a good shot by Reepex. He's going to need to do more though, because it's not already in, but he will get some people to commit. There it goes! One goal by Reepex. Brilliant setup. Really good setup. He's pretty happy with himself. He air rolls to put that one on target, and Jessie just can't make it to the ball. I think Jessie expected to be able to reach that, but Reepex with the boost is able to catch up to it. They're weaklings who just overwhelm you. Yeah, it's like if you ever play against Zerg in StarCraft 2, or StarCraft at all, there are so many. You think that you've beaten them all, but then there's always another one there. That's just, I don't know what Reepex is trying to do there. That's not a good play by him. He just panicked. I should ask Scrubkiller's dad if he would come down for one of the meetups. It would be cool, or could he come with Marky? Yeah, I'm sure that we'll get Scrub to one of the Scrub and his dad to one of the Scotland Rocket League meetups one day. We'll definitely have more of those. We've got to meet the Scotland Rocket League gang. Got to meet everybody. It's pretty cool how many people. Well, for me at least, it's really cool meeting all of these new people through Rocket League. It's something like a year ago, that wasn't even something that I considered as a possibility. Like, I knew Rocket League was a game and I was playing it with my real-life friends, but yeah, it's pretty crazy how much has changed in a year with Rocket League. Okay, a bit of midfield play here. That's a nice first touch off the wall by Reepex, but he gets a little bit ahead of himself. He could have dribbled that one down to the ground and pinched it. Looked for a 50-50 at worst, but oh, that's not what he was looking for. Not able to get the ball clear. He's kind of running out of boost this whole time. That's why we see him flipping more. Nice pass by Stocki, actually. Well played. Turn on unlimited boost to help the player that's alone. Now, we're just leaving it as... Like, the thing with them new game modes... The passing play! Jessie and Doomsee! Oh my goodness, wait a minute, let's take a look at this one. Doomsee sets it to Jessie, and Jessie just waits for Reepex to overcommit. Look at that passing play! By the Zero Boost Legends. He got baited. What was I saying? Oh yeah, I was saying with new game modes, if you want to find like the perfect balance, you just change one rule at a time. So what have we changed with this one? Well, all we've changed is the amount of players in each team and the boost rules. That's it. So we don't want to change too much. Oh, Remkoe missed the open net, but it's okay. Jessie and Doomsee are both there to team up again. Yeah, it's alright, Scrub. I'll get another lobby after this one. I'll get another lobby after this one. You can play for sure. Doomsee feels so much better now that Reepex is getting rinsed. Remkoe must be feeling really good about himself. Remkoe must be feeling really good about this. But yeah, in the future, I'm sure if... What was that noise? Noises. Yay, Splash Leet. Thanks so much, dude. Yeah, we kind of just stumbled on this idea yesterday, and it turned out to be a ton of fun. I highly, highly recommend you to play this game with four of your friends when you're all in comms together. It's really funny. I listened to Mike Rules, Yummy Cheese Man, Quinn Lobdell, Dumbo, and all the mind games. Reepex doesn't bite this time. I can't remember who's the fifth player again. It was Mike, Quinn, Yumi, Dumbo, and Jessie, of course. Jessie was in this lobby, he played as well. And they were on comms, and it was just hilarious. Like, listening to them, the team of four, like, making battle plans as they tried to take down the team of what, or the solo player, it was hilarious. So, yeah, definitely try to play this game with four of your friends. I highly recommend it. And yeah, 4v1, we just did that because four is the most, I think... Four is the most people that you can get in one team, isn't it? You can't get five in a team. Let me check. Can you get five in a team? I don't think. But yeah, I don't know. Four. We just did four because they literally had five people, and we're like, okay. 4v1. Easy. That's what you do with five people. But yeah, maybe 3v1 is better. We'll see. We'll just stick with this one for now, though. What is Reepex doing here? Oh. I don't know. I don't know why Reepex turned there. He can still beat Doomsee. He really shouldn't have let that goal go in. He's now... No, he's one goal ahead of Doomsee now. But Reepex giving away that goal is definitely a misplay. He's risking getting scored on by an incredible last second keepy up team play. Oh, and that's maybe the beginning of it. Doomsee really wanting to beat Reepex here. Sends the ball to the ground. Jessie keeps it very high. Reepex to the air. Remkoe. Oh, Stocki comes in and hits it down. No, Doomsee says in the chat, because that's going to give negative 10 to Reepex. I still think that was a huge misplay at the end there by Reepex to just leave the ball. But he'll slot in right here in our little leaderboard. There's Reepex right above Doomsee, below Remkoe. Unbind boost. Yeah, I think these guys unbind boost. Unbound boost. Right, Jessie says it's his turn. We're gonna get Jessie, I believe, in the solo team. Then that will just leave Stocki. Oh wait. Okay, there we go. That's better. So we're gonna. No, that's not right. Come on. Guys, please. Please. Finally, Jessie joins the right team. What a muppet. He doesn't realize that the team of one has always been orange. Just joins the blue team. But we finally get the teams organized. Let's see if Jessie, the player with definitely the most experience in this game mode out of anybody in this lobby, we'll see how he can do. This is our big chance. Throw will be awkward to save. Oh, Doomsee barely puts it over the crossbar. And that's a good contest as well by Stocki. Jessie on the retreat. But he does make it back in time. Jessie definitely looking pretty organized. Remco is going to look for the bump. We have to bear in mind that out of the four players on the blue team, in every game before this one, Jessie was the most aggressive with regards to bumping. So is somebody else going to step up on blue team and take that role just to put some pressure on Jessie and kind of prevent him from keeping track of his boost and positioning? Jessie's boost is getting pretty low, but that is a fantastic challenge. He was very much on his last legs when it came to boost, so it was important that he got a hard hit on that ball. Pretty surprised he turned to face that ball, actually, but it's kind of worked out for him. Manages to keep it level. He hasn't conceded, and we're a minute into the game, so looking pretty good for Jessie. I would definitely get off the wall if I were him. Decent first touch. He's got to be careful, and he is. Anytime that you're entering the corner, you open yourself up to, you know, getting completely out of position and wrong-footed. So, yeah, right like that. I feel like going in the corner is so risky in this matchup. Putting your back to the ball. Because even if you do get it past, like, one, two, or even three people, there's always that last guy. Whoa, what? How did Reepex get that ball into the middle? Excuse me? Was it even Reepex? No, it was... Oh, it was Remkoe. Whoa, okay, hold on. I think Remkoe just got bumped upside down and he wheel hit the ball into the middle. That's insane. That's kind of lucky, to be honest, but how did he do that? He got bumped and then the undercarriage of his car, like, bopped the ball into the center. That's ridiculous. I thought it was Reepex, but turns out Remkoe, with the sickest pass we've seen all day, that was next level. Even on the second watch, I still don't fully comprehend what just happened. Mainly because I thought it was Reepex, and then I was like, wait, oh, it was Remkoe. These guys' names look too similar. Okay, Jessie, still, you know, this score, after what we've seen happening to Doomsee and Reepex, is definitely good, but now we're seeing Doomsee, okay, he backs off. I feel like Doomsee should have definitely just stayed on Jessie right there. He had a chance to chain bump Jessie, and what I mean by that is, after you bump the solo player one time, you've got him. What a save by Jessie! Oh my goodness, the ball halfway in, but he keeps it out. He showed a lot of respect to the shot right there, just knowing it was going in and not barely hitting the post. But like I was saying, Doomsee, he did have a chance to keep bumping Jessie, but he decided to drive away. Maybe a misplay. There's the second goal, though, by the aforementioned. Good positioning. Oh, that was really nice positioning, actually. Perfect power slide by Doomsee. What are the rules? Goal of this mode? The rules are that the team of four are not allowed to use boost. The solo player is allowed to use boost, but the team of four are not allowed to use boost. And I have to point out, Remkoe actually scored four goals. He scored four times against the team of four, and since Remkoe has switched onto the team of four, they've only conceded one goal in three games. And this we're not finished the third game, but Remkoe, he might actually be right. This guy is turning around the defensive capabilities of the team of four, for sure. He's been just chilling at the back, like he's used to doing in 3v3. Oh, that's a good goal, though, by Jessie. Remkoe didn't respect that one. You see Remkoe driving off the line here, because he expects that he's going to be first to the ball, but Jessie actually, right underneath it, gets up just high enough. Remkoe had the advantage of VSing a team that had never played the boostless guys before. That's true, but, I mean, Jessie was on the boostless team, and he had done it before. But Jessie, he's still got the best score so far, so Jessie putting up a pretty good showing. He's had the best defense as a solo player, but oh, there's his third goal. Doomsee is in the right place at the right time again. There we go, Doomsee just finding a gap for himself, and he must be pretty glad that Reepex left that, because Reepex, he thought about jumping in the way of that one. Does Stocki actually got a dunk right there? And he could steal the boost after centering this ball just to deny Jessie taking it. Obviously he can't use it, but he can steal it. Okay, Reepex could center the ball well. He kind of does. Oh, perfect play by Stocki as well. The pass was what made this possible, though. Reepex just had to make sure to get this ball as horizontally as possible across the field. Good read by Stocki to get the rebound so quick, because Jessie was there. And now he's three down. Remkoe finished off four goals down, losing 8-4. So Jessie's still in the lead, but he has to hold on for another minute and 30 seconds. Has to hold on for a minute and 30 seconds. It's a good turn. He's pressuring again. I really liked how Jessie was playing at the start of the game. He went a whole minute without being scored on, because he just kind of played keep away. He was very much just concerned with his own boost situation, trying to keep the ball away from the team of four, which is, it seems like a good strategy. unfortunate play right there. Oh, Reepex the chance and he's, oh, he is gonna miss. What? Oh my goodness, Doomsee misses as well. Oh no, Reepex and Doomsee missing open net after open net. Now Stocky's the chance, he's gonna miss the open net, but Reepex is there for the pass. Is the team of four just communicating, or are they just playing? I think they're just playing. Okay, Stocki might... Yeah, he went for the pass there, to be fair. He decided that the pass was a higher percentage play than the shot, which might be true, because shooting with a low boost is sometimes a bit more difficult than you imagine. Let's see, can Jessie hold it at four? If he holds it at four, he ties Remco's score of -4. Oh, but he could definitely score an unsavable goal here. Goes for the top of the goal, but he can't get it underneath the crossbar. And now Remkoe with the interference. That's exactly what I was talking about earlier. Consistent interference, but oh my goodness, the ball just rolls harmlessly across the goal. And a second time, this time Jessie throws himself at it. Still 20 seconds to hold. Reepex with the bump. Doomsee gets it in the top corner. What a play by Reepex. Absolutely savage. Look at that. Oh, that's great play by Reepex. He thought about going for the ball, then he realized he had a chance to just slam Jessie into the net. That's what I like to see, dude. Just going for the goalkeeper. Jessie needs to get a goal now to equalize Remkoe. And unfortunately for him, Remkoe in defense has been really on point. And I mean, Remkoe did score four goals as well, which is very impressive. And Jesse's actually gonna own goal. Making his own chances even worse. Jessie trying to put the ball wide of the net, but he accidentally scores, maybe for the Brazil, but I really think that was probably a misplay by Jessie. He was trying to put it wide of his own net. Scores by mistake. Yeah, Reepex, I mean, on the attacking side of things, Reepex has been pretty good. But defensively, Reepex crumbled against the four bots that were chasing him around. The professional bots. That's going to do it. Jessie, -6 in the end. He did finish off with the Brazil. So considerably better than Reepex and Doomsee. But Remkoe stays in first place. There's the scoreboard right here. Okay. Maybe the solo guy needs unlimited boost. Maybe 3v1 is more fair. Oh wait. Is there a name and password for this? I think so, Remkoe. Who wants in? He's gonna restart. Yeah, I know it. Well, alright, yeah. Even if I don't know it, then I'll just remake it. Hold on, let me see if I can invite Remkoe back. Oh, what was the name again? I remember the password. Yeah, I remember. Oh, Remco's gonna laugh at the password. Slow boost recharge. We'll see. Don't worry, we'll experiment different things today. We're just trying to come up with a cool new game mode. Yeah, we managed to get it. Oh, dude. So the only player who didn't get a chance to play yet is Stocki. Can Stocki beat Remkoe, who did go first and come up with the best score? And I mean, scoring four goals against the team of four is pretty impressive at this point. How did the donation go for Dumbo last night? It was completed in just 3.5 hours, which is amazing. For those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, Yumi Cheese Man in chat started... Oh, wait, hold up! The pinch kickoff. These guys truly are the bots. Inspired play coming in from them. Just beautiful pinch kickoff. Holy cow. I wonder if that's ever going to happen again. That was insane. And then the center ball. Stocki just completely caught out by that kickoff, though. But I was telling you guys, yeah, Yumi Cheese Man, he started up a stream with a donation goal to get Dumbo to land. Dumbo, a much-loved and high-rated Australian Rocket League player. And he was going to go to the European RLCS LAN, well, the Lansterdam, if you will. But he had to... he had to cancel his trip because his job didn't pan out like he had anticipated. But fortunately for him, the Rocket League community, led by Mike Rules, managed to put together enough money in a donation train to get Dumbo to land. So Dumbo's going to be there. I'm excited to meet him. I think $1,400 was raised in 3.5 hours just to get Dumbo a plane ticket to Amsterdam. So that's pretty awesome. It's a shame we couldn't get him the plane ticket home. He's going to be stuck in Europe for the rest of his life, but he doesn't know that yet. We didn't tell him that part. I'm sure he'll be happy to be there, all the same. Anyway, oh my goodness, that's a overcommit by Stocki. Surely a goal. Not even Doomsee can miss from this range. And there's the third goal. Doomsee's got them all. Doomsee was his third goal in 41 seconds. The name was Heatwave? No, the password for the, or the name for the lobby was Heatmap, I believe. Heatmap. Alright, Stocki not looking good here. He's only one goal ahead of Remco's record so far. And there's lots of time left. That's a good reactive save. Doomsee was looking for his fourth goal right there. But will Stocki even be able to score a goal past Remkoe, who has looked absolutely imperious at the back? Even without boost, this guy, one of the best sweepers in Europe. Look at that, his entire team actually deserting him. They just know that Remco's more than fine, all by himself. Could I try and get Cuxer in this game mode? Yeah, I'd love to. I'll throw him a message after this. Look at this passing by blue team again. As long as blue team stays spread out, it's so hard to get the ball past all of them if you are Stocki. You might get a post pinch here. There it is. Maybe a misplay by Jessie. I'm not sure if he had boost there, but he could have stolen the boost in the corner to deny it from Stocki. But regardless, Remkoe just with another easy interception on the well. Stocki throwing himself at the ball. Not a good play. He doesn't like this at all, does Stocki? He's down by 4. 4-0. It's the ultimate challenge. If anybody can win the 1v4, what is the point here? To get the least goals scored against you? Yeah, that's like that's the secondary objective. Obviously, the main objective is to win. There's nothing stopping the player in the solo team to win the game. Like, you could just win, right? But if you can't win, then letting the scoreline be as low as possible is the next best thing to do. That's, oh, so close. Stocki going for the unsavable shot because, of course, you can't jump to save a shot that is right underneath the crossbar. And the blue team were not ready to go off the wall. Stocki, going for a block, actually jumps over the ball right there. This is a big chance. Will you get the ball across into the middle? I feel like it's going to be pretty tough to score this one. All of blue team now back in a massive wave. Like annoying wasps. They follow the ball everywhere it goes. Oh, Doomsee with a mind game. This guy... that's his fourth goal of the game. Look at this mind game by Doomsee. He's just waiting for Stocki to commit. And then, oh, sticks it inside. Valeni, thanks for the Twitch Prime sub, my friend. Welcome to the channel. I appreciate that support, dude. Hope you're enjoying the 1v4s. Doomsee's saying that he thinks he actually plays better without boost than he does with boost. And I mean, with a performance like this, I can't agree more. Doomsee should just stop using boost. It would definitely help his team's chances qualifying for the RLCS. You can also give the booster unlimited boost. Yeah, we're definitely going to try that one. That's a good suggestion, for sure. Give the player on the solo team unlimited boost just so he can zoom around even more and be the ultimate speed differential. But that's the sixth goal, tying up Reepex. Stocki, 2 minutes and 5 seconds to hold on. If he can score one goal, he'll be ahead of Reepex. But that's just like so aggressive by Stocki. I don't know why he's going off the well right there. They're like cats chasing a laser pointer. You're not wrong. It's a good kick off by Stocki, taking multiple people out of the game. But Remkoe, as always, solid as a rock at the back. And that's probably the worst recovery I've ever seen by Remkoe right there. I was about to say Remkoe, one of the best players at recovering fast, and then he lands on his back. Typical. At least I didn't speak before I saw what he was doing. But will Stocki hold on? This is currently tied with Reepex for second place, but you know, Reepex did score a goal, which is arguably more impressive. Is losing 7-1 better than losing 6-0? Some might say that you could find a brighter day. But we'll see. Remkoe actually looking for the bump now. Oh no, it wasn't Remkoe, it was what do you call him? Jessie, unsurprisingly. Jessie's always looking for the bumps. Okay, Stocki manages to not get scored on for about 50 seconds in a row here, but he needs to be so careful. Oh my goodness, so aggressive! Gets the double touch on the 50-50, or else he might have got that one sent past him. And oh my goodness, he's just going... He's opting into 50-50s, which I kind of have to disagree with. I'm not sure if that's a good idea, unless you know that you're getting a really, really good angle on a 50-50. It's probably a misplay. Oh, and he can't get the read off the crossbar. Jessie does, though. And now it's just a matter of, will Stocki be able to hold on, prevent the blue team from scoring three more goals and tying him up with Reepex in fourth place? Do I remember when Mike got dunked on by Marbo? Yeah. Oh, Jessie again showing us just how much he can do by annoying Stocki. This time it doesn't work. Well played by Stocki. And Remkoe in his natural habitat, sitting in defense. He's very confident, it would seem. Not even moving. And he just knows, Remkoe knows exactly the dimensions of his goal. Look at that, just waiting for the ball to hit the crossbar. Good recovery by Stocki though, puts it wide. Can I get Shogun? Well obviously if I get Shogun in this game mode as the single player, he just won't concede because Shogun is the best defender in the world. So we could, if we want to see how this is done, we could get Shogun. I'm sure you guys would enjoy that a lot. I definitely need to cast more with Greasy and Jacob. That was hilarious when I casted with those boys the other day. They're pretty funny as casters. Oh my goodness, Remkoe with the wall shot. What a shot for the zero boost team. Stocki needs to hold on two more goals. Oh, what a shot by Remkoe. Really nice. 8-0 in their favor. Blue team have looked so good with Remkoe on their team. They're just not getting scored on. You thought that was Dogu? Oh my goodness, this could be dangerous. Remkoe goes for the goal and he finds it. Stocky's looking like he needs to just play super safe right now. Unless he wants to get tied on with Reepex. Doomsee take two more, come on! Oh no, Doomsee wanting to get two more goals past Stocki so that he's not the worst. Reepex only needs one for Stocki to be tied with him. What's Stocki gonna do? Oh, he's going for the ball. If he gets dunked on, it could be danger, but he gets the win. 5 seconds, will he hold on? Stocki machine goes for the goal. It's gonna be an absolute nightmare to keep it up, and they can't. Doomsee with a no in the chat, because that means that last place, after all is said and done, is poor Doomsee. And I actually forgot the negatives right there. There we go. Final scores, unlimited boost. GG's, boys. Unlimited boost is a good one. Next time. GG's. Anyway, let me just go over this. Yeah, final scores we have for the lobby. Oops, I just resized my OBS. There's the final scores. So Remkoe is the winner. Remkoe the winner with -4. He actually lost 8-4, which is pretty impressive given how badly everybody else lost. Jessie lost 7-1. He got Brazil'd, so second place for Jessie. Third place for Stocki with -9, Reepex -10, and then Doomsee, -11, getting demolished. And Remkoe saying prize, please. Remkoe, you are the winner of today's pride pool. Congratulations. He takes home the entire pride pool of the day. Remkoe just unbeatable, apparently. Doomsee was relying on pure speed to win, but it didn't go as planned. Oh, Zenovia, the biggest Remkoe fangirl. But hold on, let me...